Let's take a vote on it. Which do you want to do this one or not?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you have any go? Are you happy to do this one? It's a tricky little piece, this one. Quite a tricky little piece, this. It's it was recorded by the Coon Sanders Nighthawks Orchestra in the mid-20s. They were a famous white broadcasting band. Now, they recorded this. It was became more or less their signature tune. And it's composed by two members of the band, Carlton Coon, who was the drummer, and Sanders, who was the pianist. And it's called Here Comes My Ball and Chain.
Thank you.
that look like Dixieland? Sure, that looks like Dixieland. Doesn't that look like Alabama? Watch all that. Birmingham, is there any place so nice? Do I have to ask you twice? Yes, sir, that's my paradise. Doesn't that smell like ham and eggs? No, that smells like bacon and eggs, ham and eggs, oh gee. Mr. Lindbergh made Perry, the I-vote vote, all heaven only, so ain't no land like Dixieland to me. Sorry, Mike. It's on this album. It's a tune. Now the chaps are getting afraid. Now I'm going to insult them. This is an album. This is one of those antediluvian things called a frisbee. That's right. There, right. It came out about nearly 20 years ago now. The High Society album. They are on sale, as I said, for £5 at less, and £10 on the internet. There's a tune on there which I wrote myself. Can read the words here. It's a tune. It's all about the hot dance craze, to end all hot dance crazes. I could read you what it says here, actually. There we are. The dance craze to end all dance crazes, a subtle blend of symphonic romanticism, neoclassical revisionist pomposity, and downright vulgarity, which Jack Hilton, despite many attempts, never quite succeeded in capturing. And it's called Varsity Blue Bottom Wobble. Varsity drag, I can't read that. Oh, wait, oh, yes. The elders, they break away, they hop, they all black bottoms, show a god of them, where will it stop? The dance floor sensation that's sweeping the nation gives more than a glimpse of a stocking. A posterior antic, it drives people frantic, to dance hall and club they come flocking. To learn how to do it, just go to the zoo, then look at the monkeys and ape what they do. Believe me, folks, it's true. The young clearly have a natural flair for it. In schools and colleges, all seem to care for it. This is what they do. The teachers and pupils, they never have scruples, but take to the floor at the double. Everyone fond of it, quick to latch onto it, varsity blue bottom wobble. Babies and prams, and newly born lambs, and granddads who shuffle and hobble. As deadly as howitzer, no escape, now it's the varsity blue bottom wobble. Cretins and kings, daughters and dukes, felons and cops who restrain us. They're all the names under this latest craze, the whole of society from apex to base. Ah, oh, down on your knees, oh what a wheeze, hands on the floor without trouble. Never a care, wave it all in the air, the varsity blue bottom wobble. To Fletcher Henderson, who was, of course, a pioneer of big band jazz and probably the first commercially successful arranger of jazz for a big band or for any kind of music for a big swing band. As he, of course, became the staff arranger for Benny Goodman's orchestra in the 30s. There somewhere. Right, we're going to play some tunes that Fletcher Henderson recorded. And he recorded some of the most difficult tunes known to people who play classic jazz. We're going to attempt some of them. The first one was one of the ones he recorded while the brief period of about a year when he had Louis Armstrong as his solo trumpet player. And it's a Don Redman arrangement of a tune which was currently popular at the time, which was late 1925. And it's called Money Blues.
Thank you.
Charlestons. Charlestons were very popular, of course, at the time when the dance called the Charleston was popular. There's a tune called The Charleston, or Charleston, South Carolina, which we may be playing later on. Depends how much time we have. We have a large program to get through. And this is one of my favorite Charlestons, as I said. It's a tune recorded by Henderson with a slightly smaller group than he usually used, called the Dixie Stompers. And it's by Billy Mayer, or Billy Meyer, and Elmer Schobel. Elmer Schobel was quite a well-known pianist and composer at the time, a white man. And I can only assume that either one or the other, or both of the composers, came from the city of Philadelphia, because it's called Brotherly Love. I want to be himself, and I think he arranged this one as well. It's a lovely 12 bar. It's a lovely idea. It's got a wonderful chromatic movement at the beginning in the first four bars, which is always the creative part of a 12 bar blues. It's always where they differ. Good heavens! Well, I didn't realize that. Hi, good heavens. Well, what can I say? certainly have. I almost think that poor animal there was dosed with what we're going to play now, which is hot mustard.
foxtrot again. It's easy to get away from.
I say, he's changed the tape. Totally good. Good. Thank you. Oh, he's taking the pressure off me. Something wrong. That's lovely. Thank you. Right. It's easy to be glib about the next number, but I once heard a band of young girls, in fact, and young men, play this number in Sweden, in Malmö, I think it was, about 10 years or more ago. I thought, gosh, that's pretty good of them to attempt that. Until it dawned on me that they were actually playing it in the key of B flat, which makes it, of course, a lot lower and quite a lot easier. Because the original is actually in the key of D. Now, Henderson was well known for playing in funny keys like that. They know quite a number of tunes they played were in the key of D. And this is no exception. We don't play in girls' keys, as Rico says. Now this is probably one of the most difficult tunes ever written. I think can only think of one which is a little bit more difficult, and I'm working on that at the moment. I hope to get it ready for tonight, but I didn't get it ready in time. It needs a lot of rehearsal anyway, and that one's Whiteman Stomp. But this is, I think, probably just as difficult, probably more difficult for the clarinet players. We did have a run through of it earlier on, and we're all going to give it a go. So no, it's not that. Come on, girls, so we're going to play one of the tunes that Fats Waller wrote for Henderson and exchanged for a massive feed of about 15 hamburgers, so the story goes. It's all right. And a Harlem hamburger store where Fats was down on his luck and really starving. So he said to Fletcher Henderson, who of course was in big money at that time, playing at the Roseland Ballroom with his band. And he said to Henderson, "Yeah, I've got a few tunes here. You know, you want to? I'll let you have them. You can record them. You know." So I'm really hungry. So Henderson bought him this huge feed, and this is one of the tunes. It's called Henderson Stomp. One as well. This is nice. I haven't got a note of the composers. Somebody has somewhere, but it's a tune called Shuffling Sadie, and it was recorded by the Dixie Stompers, Henderson's pseudo band, on the Harmony label in 1927, and it's called Shuffling Sadie. Thank you. Probably refers to something else of a sexual nature which is long forgotten in the mists of time, you know. Most of these things do when you when it's analysed.
Have it ready.
Finish this set with this Fletcher Henderson salute, as it were. Too many tributes have been paid to him, so we're just going to salute him. Captain. Captain Henderson. Now, this one he recorded, it's by Leslie and Mills, that's right. Irving Mills got in everything, he was a publisher. But I'm not sure who the Leslie was. This was a tune of 1931, which Henderson recorded in 1931. And it was named after the craze of the time, which was everybody had to have a radio, and you had to listen to the band on the radio in the evening. Everybody stayed in to hear the famous bands on the radio. And so this one is called Radio Rhythm. Wireless, yeah, but they never called it the wireless in the States. It was only in England it was called the wireless.
More or less.
You see, you've got to remember, yes, wireless rhythm's not quite the same. Maybe the Savoy Orpheans would have played wireless rhythm, but Henderson Band, being an American band, you see, we've got a significantly different vocabulary, haven't we, Jim? There's lots of words, American.
Because if you think about it for a second, a radio is a much more descriptive term, because there are many things in the world that are wireless,
exactly.
But there's only one thing that's a radio.
That's precisely... That is precisely the point I was going to make. American... I was going to say, American vocabulary is much more specific. Take the example of an elevator. It describes what it does. A lift doesn't. You can have a lift in a car. It doesn't, you see, it doesn't tell you what it is. A pavement is just a paved area. It could be anywhere. A sidewalk tells you what it is. And it's the same with the radio. As Jim said, it tells you what it is. Rhythm also tells you what it is, and this is what these boys have got. They've got rhythm in abundance, man. So here we go with Radio Rhythm, and this is the last one from this set.